Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, up till now we have looked at how to insert the element at various position in a doubly linked list. First condition we have check is start, okay, then we check at the end position, and next was your any random position. That position was chosen by the user. Similarly, we can also delete the node from start position, end position, or we can say any random position chosen by the user in a given linked list. Okay, so again three conditions are going to be followed up. First is your position which user has chosen is the start of the node. Next will be end of the linked list, and third will be your any random position chosen by the user in a given linked list. So we defined a function called as deleteAtPosition. We have defined a function called as deleteAtPosition. Okay. So we are going to have the value where user wants to delete that position is going to be stored in the variable called as position. Okay. Now let's take a condition. User wants to delete the node at position number 1. Okay. In that case, if position equal to 1, user has chosen to delete the value given at position number 1. It means that our size is also going to be 1 only. Okay, so we are going to have the size value also 1. We are going to check if size equal to 1. What it means, there is only one node present in a given linked list, and that particular node is only to be deleted by the user. So in that case, what happens is that position is equal to 1 and also your size is equal to null also. It means that we are going to have the size values as 1. It means we have only one node. So position equal to 1 and the size is also equal to 1. It means we need to have the start and end again equal to none only. Okay. So if position equal to 1, and then we are going to check the size. If size equal to 1, it means we are going to delete the first node. Deleting the first node. First and only node in the linked list, or we can say doubly linked list. Okay, so in that case our start will point to null, end will point to null, and size will come to 0, and this value need to be written. As you may be remembering that if size equal to 0, it means there is no node present in the given linked list. So the last value which we had of this size was that we are checking is it first node. If size equal to 1, we are deleting the particular node, and after that we need to return the size value. So size value become again 0. So in that case size will become 0. Okay, this is how we are going to point. If it is not, if size is not equal to 1, okay, in that case what we have is that we are going to check the various value. If size is 1, then after that we need to have the pointers for pointing at the proper locations. So to do this we are going to have the value. So for that I'm going to point the start value as start dot get link next. So whatever the value of next is there, that is in this case is going to be null. Okay, so start is going to call that particular method. Okay, so start dot get link next will be stored into the start. Okay, now start is going to point to someone else. Now previous value of start is going to be what? Now none. Okay, so I'm saying start dot set link of previous. Okay, previous is going to be pointing to null. Okay, so previous is going to point to null. After that, we are going to decrement the value of size. So size B is decremented value is what? Size minus 1. So it becomes size minus minus. And these all values are to be returned back to the calling function. Okay. Now, if size is not equal to 1, what it then we are going to check size equal to position. It means we are going to have the deletion at the end. Okay, so it means position equal to size. So let's say user chosen to choose to delete a value called as number 5, and our size is also 5. It means that we have 5 nodes. So user has chosen to store or delete, we can say, the value, the node at position number 5. That is the end of the linked list. So we can say user has chosen to delete a node present at the last of the linked list. In that case, position equal to size. Let's say we have size as 5. So position equal to 5. So we are deleting the last node in the given linked list. Okay. So if position equal to size, deleting last node of doubly linked list. Okay. In that case, what happens? Just like we are going to have the end value equal to end dot get link previous. Okay. In case of star value of position number 1, we are going to have the next. And in case of this one, end dot link list get previous value. And we are going to set next link of the end. Okay. In case of last one, end dot set link of next equal to null. Okay. So end dot set link value of the next variable as null. Okay. And after this, we are going to decrement the size value. Okay. So you need to remember which position is there. First position, in that case, start dot previous value is null. If star end is there, then end dot next is there, value is previous is there, and next will be null. So you understand that it is going to be the end of the linked list. Okay. So after this, we are going to have the random position. We have done with the first node deletion, then we have done with the end position deletion. Now we are going to have the random position. To get these values, we need to write down node PTR. PTR is the object. Okay. So start dot get link next, we get the value of the next variable and put it point to the PTR. Okay. Then we start with I value equal to 2. We are not starting with I value as 1, because for that I have written a function called as if position equal to 1. You are going to check the size equal to 1, and then we are going to call to particular value. So we are going to start from the next node, that is second position. Okay. So hence, for the iteration, I am going to use I equal to 2, and I will go until size. Okay. So I start from 2 to size. So I equal to 2, I less than equal to size. Clear? After that, once we are done with this one iteration, we are going to check if I equal to position, our iteration and the position where user wants to delete the node is matching. Okay. That is the particular node which the user wants to delete. Okay. So if I equal to position, we need to write down the values. Okay. So node P equal to PTR dot get link of previous. So previous value will be transferred to P. P will be having previous link. And similarly, N will be having next link. Okay. Then we need to have the values to be set. So we are calling P object dot set link next equal to N. Okay, so P's next link, okay, will be pointing to N, and N previous will point to P. Okay, so N dot set link previous will point to P. Like this, we have stored the values. Okay, so we can delete the particular node from the given position. Once that is done, we need to decrement the value of size. That's why I'm writing size minus minus. Once this is done, we need to return these particular values. So I'm returning values. Okay. So we have already done with this one. Now what remains is that we need to have the value of pointer. So we are going to write PTR equal to PTR dot get link next. So PTR is going to have the value of the next element. So PTR is going to have the value of next. Like this, we can point to the values. Okay. So keep in mind, while deleting, we need to check with the three position. First is the start. In case of start, your position will be equal to 1, and your size will also be equal to 1, since we have only one node present at the element. Okay. Then we will check at the end of the linked list, and after that we will be checking any random position in a given doubly linked list. Since we are dealing with the doubly linked list, make sure you have the values of next and previous intact properly. If you misplace with intact of values of next and previous, what happens is that you might lose the entire linked list also. Okay, let's take an example. If by mistake I'm writing n dot value of a particular node as null, what it means, we are going to end the linked list at that particular position only. So the further links are going to be misplaced. So keep in mind that you need to have the values at proper position of start and end. Also, the object through which you are going to call the values is to be proper one. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to Ekeeda channel.